For more than 30 years, Baxter and the Baxter International Foundation have proudly supported the Foster McGaw program. Like its namesake, Foster McGaw Prize recipients demonstrate a passion for community health and an exceptional commitment to developing innovative partnerships that improve the health and well-being of their communities. Our work at the Baxter International Foundation is rooted in collaborating with organizations around the globe to improve health outcomes for the people and communities who need it the most. The Foster McGaw honoree recipients bolster community-focused work by demonstrating that hospitals and health systems working with community partners can be the cornerstone of a healthier America.
Thank you, Dr. Arroyave. We appreciate the Baxter International Foundation's continued generous support of the Foster G. McGaw Prize. The prize was created in 1986 to recognize excellence in community service and the local partnerships that make it possible. The American Hospital Association is pleased to continue the long and proud tradition of partnering with the Baxter International Foundation because we share the common goal of increasing access to health care for all, especially the underserved and most vulnerable in our society. Now, as we all know, COVID-19 has changed our lives and tested us like never before. At the same time, the challenges of the pandemic brought out the best in so many people, inspiring selfless acts of caring and compassion as we fought together against the most dangerous health threat of our lifetime. We can never say thank you enough to the doctors, nurses, and other heroic health providers who battled exhaustion every day, but refused to give up and continue their efforts today. Meanwhile, even as the battle against COVID-19 goes on, we must also recognize and address many other barriers that stand in the way of advancing health for all. This year's awardees have been leading the way by harnessing the power of community partnerships to champion changes that will advance health for everyone. Working with community partners, they found innovative and strategic ways to confront hunger, violence, and many of the other social determinants of health that have such a negative impact on keeping people healthy and healthcare costs affordable. Their communities are healthier and stronger because of their efforts. Together, they've made a huge difference in the lives of millions of Americans. The women and men who work in these organizations are so special because they embody a dedication to caring, compassion, excellence, and community leadership. We weren't able to present the prize last April, as we ordinarily do at our annual meeting. What a time that was, when the entire country was heading full steam into lockdown mode. So this year, as we see a future of hope in the development and distribution of effective vaccines, we're in a better place to make these recognitions. It's a special honor to resume recognition of the outstanding work by our members and present the 2019 Foster McGaw Prize to the winner and our three finalists. ProMedica, the winner of the Foster McGaw Prize, is a great example of how successful partnerships improve the health and well-being of local communities. In fact, my good friend Randy Ostra, ProMedica's president and CEO and former member of the AHA Board of Trustees, has provided outstanding national leadership in creating awareness and encouraging others to get involved in efforts to address food insecurity. In 2015, along with AARP, he co-founded the Root Cause Coalition, of which AHA is a member and proud to play a part. This national effort provides research, advocacy, and education around the social determinants of health. Today, it's grown to include more than 100 hospital, health systems, nonprofit, and other community-based organizations, all working toward the same goal of helping individuals and communities reach their highest potential for health. ProMedica focuses on meeting the most basic human needs, such as food, healthcare, social acceptance, and healthy interpersonal relationships, with love and compassion at the center of its mission. One of the areas they've made a very significant contribution in is fighting hunger. Let me give you some examples. Working with community partners, the ProMedica team screens hospital patients for chronic hunger and directs them to area food banks if necessary. ProMedica opened Market on the Green, a full-service grocery store in an area of Toledo that had been a desert when it comes to finding healthy food. Beyond just providing food, they've taken it into the kitchen. On the second floor of the market and through online platforms, they conduct cooking classes that teach good nutrition and healthy food preparation. If that's not enough, ProMedica's work goes further because Randy and his team understand that the social determinants of health are often the root cause of poor health. That's why ProMedica contributes resources, staff, and financial support to local initiatives that improve the quality of life for area residents in other ways as well, by supporting a respite care facility for individuals with physical and developmental disabilities that serve all, regardless of ability to pay, providing assistance and services to at-risk mothers and fathers-to-be in Lucas County, Ohio, and leading an initiative that educates middle and high school students about how violence and bullying and the need to create healthy relationships are critical to creating healthy communities. Fact is, they've achieved real results. For example, the Peers Educating Peers program trains 170 teen leaders each year to deliver abuse prevention presentation to thousands of their fellow teens in Northwest Ohio. The result? A documented sharp decrease in high school bullying from 2011 to 2017. Whether it's funding the salaries of school nurses in Toledo Public Schools or offering care coordination to pregnant women in Northwest Ohio at high risk of having poor birth outcomes, ProMedica understands that improving lives results from successful partnerships. And they've made a positive difference in the lives of so many people. It's an honor today to present the Foster G. McGaugh Prize to Randy Ostra. His unwavering passion, dedication, and commitment to patients and communities is an inspiration to the entire field. Congratulations to Randy and the entire ProMedica team.
Thank you, Rick. ProMedica's mission to improve health and well-being drives our commitment to meet the health needs of those within and outside of our healthcare walls. At the organization, we recognize that we cannot and should not do this work alone, which is why we count numerous community organizations among our allies in addressing the healthcare and basic needs of our community members. We are proud of our continued efforts to raise awareness about hunger as a health issue and other social determinants of health through various programs such as the ProMedica Food Clinic. That program provides patients identified by their physicians as food insecure with healthy food, nutrition counseling, and referrals to community partners for additional assistance.
Three other remarkable health systems have earned Foster McGaugh finalist honors. Freeman Health System treats every patient like they would a member of their own family. For Freeman, this translates to meeting the needs of all community members with compassion, dignity, and respect. In doing so, Freeman has distinguished itself with its effective area alliances and innovative partnerships. When it comes to housing, Freeman provides long-term housing options to young adults with emotional issues. When it comes to education, Freeman offers learning opportunities to students looking for a future career in healthcare. When it comes to behavioral health, the organization provides education and therapy to help kids and teens to overcome behavioral and mental health issues. When it comes to seniors, they are keeping 2,800 older adults healthy and active in community life through events and education. And when it comes to children, they are improving the well-being of children with autism by providing more than 200 families with access to critical resources and services. In these and many other ways, Freeman Health System is deeply involved in the community, and that kind of community involvement changes lives forever. I'm pleased to present the finalist award to Freeman Health System's president and CEO, Paula Baker. Congratulations to you, Paula, and the entire team at Freeman Health System.
Thank you for this opportunity, Rick. Freeman Health System's story of community service is one that permeates through all ranks of the health system. We pride ourselves on supporting many community benefit organizations, which in turn help some of the most fragile members of our community. Examples include United Way of Southwest Missouri and Southeast Kansas, Joplin Family YMCA, and the Ronald McDonald House Charities of the four states. In addition, our employees have taken Freeman Health System's emphasis on service to heart, donating thousands of hours to community projects each year.
At Texas Health Resources, their faith-based mission is at the core of their partnerships and community leadership. As the mission states, our work comes from our heart. Central to their efforts are joint projects and programs with more than 25 community partners. They include associations, social and environmental organizations, chambers of commerce, churches, diversity councils, and others. THR's major programs provide a broad range of health and behavioral services, each one designed to improve, help, or sustain the life of someone in need. Let me share some examples. THR's expansion of home care options and willingness to meet patients where they are has put a focus on accessibility and convenience. More home health is possible because of many new volunteer nurses that have been recruited and trained by THR, providing compassionate care and a healing touch to thousands of area residents. Another example of leadership, making specialized care available for sexual assault survivors, highlighting the role that healthcare plays in healing and hope for victims of these traumatic events. And through its Sexual Assault Nurse Examiner, or SANE program, THR also provides education to people of all ages on how to have healthy relationships with others. This education also covers teen dating violence, human trafficking, web safety, bystander intervention, and parent awareness. In short, Texas Health Resources is making a huge difference in improving the lives of the communities they serve. I'm pleased to present this finalist award to my good friend, Barclay Berdan, CEO of Texas Health Resources. Barclay, congratulations. We are very proud of you and the THR team.
Thank you, Rick. I'm honored to accept this award on behalf of Texas Health Resources. The mission of Texas Health Resources is to improve the health of the people in the communities that we serve. We rely on our mission and our faith-based framework to create programs that improve societal well-being. We determine service offerings and design programming that help people take charge of and improve their health. From HELP, Healthy Education Lifestyles Program, which was started as a grassroots effort at one of our smaller hospitals back in 2009, to Faith Community Nursing, which leverages relationships of care and trust to touch more than 156,000 lives annually, to our Sexual Assault Nurse Examiner program, which Rick just mentioned. We know we can achieve more when we come together as a community. Our work with local leaders, businesses, and community-based organizations demonstrates a unified commitment to not only disease prevention and management, but also addressing critical issues affecting the health and well-being of our geographically and culturally diverse populations. At Texas Health, our work comes from the heart, and we take enormous pride and great joy in caring for people, our patients, our community, and each other. Thank you for this recognition.
UMass Memorial Medical Center understands that keeping a community healthy is not just about providing excellent care in a clinical setting. It's about reaching beyond the four walls of the hospital and targeting the root causes of unequal access to healthcare services. This approach is a core value of the Foster McGraw Prize. Since 2014, UMass Memorial has increased access to care for children with asthma by training community health workers who have completed nearly 700 home visits. The result? A steady decline in pediatric asthma patients in the ED because providers were able to reduce the triggers and factors that aggravate asthma in the homes. UMass Memorial has also contributed to the social well-being of the Worcester community with comprehensive initiatives such as gun buybacks, youth mental health groups, and community gardens. Working with area partners, it has tackled mental health needs and jobs and skills training, and they've assisted residents with accessing public benefits. Moreover, UMass Memorial is focused on advancing health for the future by their continued commitment in training the next generation of caregivers. It's a pleasure to present the finalist award to Dr. Eric Dixon, President and CEO of UMass Memorial Medical Center. Congratulations to you and your entire team. And I also want to recognize Doug Brown. He's not only a key leader in the organization who serves as president of UMass Memorial Community Hospitals, but Doug is also a member of the AHA Board of Trustees.
Thank you, Rick. On behalf of our UMass Memorial family, I want to thank you and the Foster McGraw Award Committee for recognizing our organization. Addressing the social determinants of health to keep our communities healthy is the work we do every day. We've spent years investing in programs that focus on workforce development for at-risk youth and develop interventions that address poverty, violence, food insecurity, and access to care. We're proud to collaborate with our community partners to jointly identify needs and leverage resources. I'm so proud of our teams that do this work. These programs make a real difference in the lives of the people we serve, and never has that been more apparent than what we've accomplished during this very challenging year. We are a stronger, better health system because of our work in the community, and I'm grateful to the Foster McGraw Award Program for showcasing this great work. Thank you.
Healthcare organizations that lift the communities around them don't happen by chance. It involves a real commitment that is sustained over time. I know that Randy, Paula, Barclay, Eric, and Doug would be the first to tell you that it requires a team effort. But we know that leadership starts at the top, and these leaders are all among the most respected, admired, and capable healthcare executives in America. They set the tone, they create the culture, they make the commitment, and they nourish the values shared by AHA and the Baxter International Foundation. Sir Winston Churchill once said, "Healthy citizens are the greatest asset any country can have." Our honorees recognize that, and they work so hard and effectively toward this goal every single day. Their partnerships, actions, and results show that hospitals and health systems can make a lasting difference in the health and well-being of our communities. Congratulations to each of them for what they are doing to advance health in America.